There is a colorful history behind the surname Plotnikov. Surnames derived from an occupation have existed in Russia from centuries past. Many of the leading scientists agree that the surname Plotnikov was derived from an occupation. This surname, at first a nickname, goes back generations. The work title itself was derived from the word raft, plot, and Plotnik was a woodworker making rafts. Later, according to Dahl's explanatory dictionary, the words zaplot and plot were used for board fences, and the word Plotnik for all people involved in woodworking, which was the fundamental craft in Russia back then. Various researchers documented rather early appearance of the Plotnikov surname. In Onomasticon by Veselovsky, there is an entry on a person whose last name was Plotnik. Plotnik Grigory Ivanovich Zabolotsky, the mid-16th century. Professor Chaikina mentions Ivashka Ivanov, Plotnikov's son, who was a craftsman from Vologda in 1648. In Russian Non-Christian Names Dictionary by Tupikov, we can find some information dated 1694 about Agapit Plotnikov, the boyar's son from Nerchinsky district, the boyar's children, servicemen category. Tracking down our family history, we can see that the most distant of our predecessors, Ivan Plotnikov, was born not later than 1672, according to the third census records. So our family goes back many generations, and our last name remained unchanged up to the 19th century, when most Russian families adopted the use of hereditary surnames. As smallholders, the Plotnikovs appeared in the genealogical sources in 1760. Ustin Tikhonovich Plotnikov, born in 1739, was mentioned as baby Vasily's father. His family belonged to the most proactive group of the smallholders. Ustin Plotnikov was a highly esteemed person, and he was among the best people reporting to the government inspectors on the smallholders of the village, under the edict of Catherine the Great. Smallholders were the offspring of the servicemen that took over Tambov region in the 16th-17th centuries. Among them were both the military, pikemen, soldiers, dragoons, artillerymen, riflemen, and the tradespeople, who were absolutely crucial for any community development. They had accent typical for Rizan and Moscow, because that's where they had come from. Over three centuries passed after the first documented Plotnikov, and his offspring still live in Starokosmodemyanskoye, a village with a great and colorful history, foundation of which is associated with the name of the national hero, Prince Dmitry Mikhailovich Pozharsky, who led Russia's struggle for independence against Polish invasion. In the early 17th century, the prince obtained his ancestral lands, containing Garetovo village and three smaller villages, Yerok, Kazinki, and Tarbeyevo. The first paper trail of the place names can be found in the cadastres by Prince Nevitsky, dated 1650-1652. Garetovo village still exists and forms a part of Tambov region. In the 17th century, the settlement belonged to the Belgorod-Eberty border, put up to suppress the nomads' raids. In the 1640s, several new forts were erected next to the Hobotovo forest. To develop and protect the territories, a significant part of Garetovo village was relocated there, the Plotnikovs among them. The settlers from Garetovo were called dragoons in the cadastre. Dragoons are the horse cavalry that can also take part in dismounted battles. Such service arm could attain combat tasks at the Sechnaya border 45 points perfectly. The dragoon's cavalry was composed of peasants, exempt from most taxes and homages. They had their own allotment and served as border guards. First dragoons from Starokosmodemyanovskoye were probably the offspring of whether the servicemen of the 16th century or the peasants, that had moved to Tambov region from all over Russia. After the borders of Russia had been expanded further south, the former servicemen finally took on farming and craftsmanship. And in the late 17th, early 18th centuries, formed the smallholders group, with the Plotnikov's family members among them. According to the list of Tambov region populated areas, Starokosmodemyanovskoye village was a state one and was located next to Vishnevka River, 35 versts from Kozlov district town and 15 versts from the camp. A wooden church was built in 1859 in Starokosmodemyanovsky Khabatets, and in 1883 the church members raised the money to set a stone church. Nikita Makarovich Plotnikov, our ancestor, was one of the most proactive participants of the project, and there is his personal signature on the petition for the building. Cosmas and Damian are two holy unmercenaries, revered by the Orthodox Church. Interestingly, there are at least three Saint Cosmas and Damian days in the Orthodox calendar of saints and feasts: July the 14th, October the 30th, and November the 14th. The Orthodox celebrate no less than three different sets of saints by the name of Cosmas and Damian, each with their own distinct feast day. Saint Cosmas and Damian of Cilicia, of Asia Minor, and of Rome. All brothers share the same spiritual profile. They were unmercenaries and famous physicians, accepting no payment for their services. Russian people acknowledged Cosmas and Damian as craftsmen, hard workers, and hearth and home protectors. There were three altars in the new stone church in Starokosmodemyanovskoye. The main one was dedicated to Saint Cosmas and Damian, and two side altars to Saint Nicholas the Wonder Worker and Saint Seraphim. Dmitry Nikitich Plotnikov got married to Maria Pavlovna Buchneva in that very church. The parish consisted of 460 households, 1,690 men, and 1,723 women. All the villagers were Great Russians. All the farmers had a piece of land equal to 12 Russian fathoms. There was a parochial school for girls and a state school for boys. Later, the village belonged to Voronezh and to Rizan regions. It has been a part of Tambov region from February 1939. Today, Starokosmodemyanovskoye belongs to Kosmodemyanovskoye rural settlement, with about 800 inhabitants, the offspring of the very first Plotnikov among them. A parish register of Starokosmodemyanovsky Khabatets village, Ilovai Camp, Kozlov County, dated 1760, contains the most ancient record of the Plotnikov's family history. According to it, Ivan Plotnikov was a smallholder and had two sons, Maxim and Tikhon. And Tikhon, in his turn, was the father of Ustin, Vasily, and Ephrem. So we start our family tree from them. We are mostly interested in the 7th census records, dated 1816. That's when the female population was first included. Thus, we get to know the name of Ephrem Ustinovich wife's, Irina, and Ilya Ephremovich wife's name, Domna. Ephrem's sons and grandsons had many children. Among them was Makar Ilyich, the great-grandfather of Anna Dmitrievna Plotnikova, who is Alexander Vladimirovich Bykov's mother, and her sisters and brother. At the age of 18, Makar Plotnikov got married to his fellow villager Feodora. They had 8 children: Stepan, Ekaterina, two Pelageyas, Ivan, Pyotr, Yelena, and Nikita. Makar Ilyich and his wife were registered as state peasants. They were mentioned as those in their daughter Ekaterina's birth certificate in 1843. We know the following about Nikita Makarovich Plotnikov, Anna Dmitrievna and her sister and brother's grandfather. He was called up for military service in the late 1870s, early 1880s. In June 1883, he had a daughter called Akilina, and 3 years later, a son called Dmitry. After the October Revolution and the beginning of the forced collectivization, according to our elder family members, those who had worked hard and therefore had solid households were labeled as kulaks. Government officials violently seized kulak farms and murdered resistors or deported them to labor camps. Dmitry Nikitovich was sent to the forced labor camp for 10 years. The Plotnikovs were deprived of everything. Maria Pavlovna and the children were hoboing about. Some people were ready to house them out of mercy, but the others wanted money, which Maria Pavlovna had very little left. Those were probably the hardest time for the Plotnikovs family, but they managed to survive. The family was truly religious and genuinely churched. According to his son Pyotr, Dmitry Nikitich was the second esteemed person in the church, after the priest. The fellow villagers always invited Maria Pavlovna to read the burial service, Christianize and give communion. She was highly respected. Dmitry Nikitich came back from exile. He didn't sour, but took what had happened as an ordeal and an act of God. Dmitry Nikitovich and Maria Pavlovna reposed in the home village Kosmodemyanovskaya. During the Second World War, over 5,000 soldiers and officers with the last name Plotnikov were killed or missed in action. Ivan Dmitrievich Plotnikov, our family member, born 1911, was among them. In July 1943, Ivan Dmitrievich Plotnikov, a machine gunner, fell in battle. He was buried in Manayenki village, Tula region, on the 18th of July, 1943. Getting back to Dmitry Nikitovich and Maria Pavlovna, we should mention that many of their children had large families. 24 grandchildren formed the new branches of the family tree. Now the Plotnikov Vorobyovs, the Plotnikov Manohins, the Plotnikov Lebedevs, the Plotnikov Bykovs keep our name worthily. Pyotr Dmitrievich Plotnikov, born in 1929 in Starokosmodemyanovskaya, was the bearer of the family name. He got married to his fellow villager Ekaterina Fyodorovna Vorobyova, that is still living in the family nest. Their children Alexei, Maria, Alexandra, and Ivan carry on the Plotnikov Vorobyov's family. Ekaterina Dmitrievna Plotnikova set a new branch of the family tree with her husband, Ivan Ivanovich Manohin. There are four children in the family, two sons, Mikhail and Vasily, and two daughters, Maria and Anna, born in the home village Khabatets-Vasilievskaya, near to Starokosmodemyanovskaya. Plotnikova Tatiana Dmitrievna got married to Dmitry Grigorievich Lebedev and left to Kasimovtown, Rязань region. The couple maintained the tradition of the number four and had three sons, Nikolai, Vladimir, Alexander, and a daughter Tatiana, that formed the third branch of the Plotnikov's family these days. Maria Dmitrievna Plotnikova left the home village after getting married to Mikhail Ivanovich Masyakin, a native of Litkarina village, Moscow region. They had nine children: Nikolai, Marina, Sergei, Alexander, Mikhail, Ivan, Alexei, Nadezhda, and Yelena. They changed surname on the way, but keep the family core and all the qualities of the Plotnikovs: open-minded, hardworking, and loving people. Plotnikova Anna Dmitrievna and Vladimir Ivanovich Bykov met in Silikat village, Lyubertsy area, Moscow region, in 1944. Anna Dmitrievna was the core of the large family of the Plotnikov Bykovs. Anna Dmitrievna and Vladimir Ivanovich raised three sons: Vladimir, Ivan, and Alexander. The family keeps growing. All the members have children, and all of them share pride of being part of the Plotnikov's history. The sprouts planted in Stara Kosmodemyanovska ages ago led to many new generations, both in and outside Russia, all over the world. And the Plotnikov's family tree keeps growing, as solid as our ancestors.
Дорогие друзья, жизнь подарила нам удивительную встречу, встречу с родными людьми. Разные судьбы, разные характеры, но у нас одни семейные гены, унаследованные от предков. Широта души, воспитание и уровень культуры, память о наших прародителях, о нашем родовом гнезде. Спасибо за поддержку в большом и нужном деле – написание истории нашего рода, где мы вспомнили основателей и носителей такой простой и в то же время такой величественной фамилии людей труда – Плотниковых.